Swami Ujjwal Bhattacharya is advisor of the All Assam Students Union. He's joining us from Guwahati, from Srinagar. Tanvir Sadiq, National Conference spokesperson. Because Omar Abdullah says Modi is responsible for this. Executive editor of Dopahar Ka Samna, representing the Shiv Sena voice in the studio, Prem Shukla. Priyanka Chaturvedi represents the Congress perspective. She's on the top right of your screen out there. Asaduddin Owaisi, president of the All India Majlis-e-Ittihad Al-Muslimin, AIMIM, joining us from Hyderabad. Kiran Rijuju, leader of the BJP, former member of parliament, and Sudhanshu Trivedi, national spokesperson of the BJP and political advisor to Rajnath Singh. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. My first question goes to Guwahati. Is this about national politics? And Swami Ujjwal Bhattacharya, from where you are, do you believe the national parties are simply taking advantage of the situation in Assam for political sniping at the national level?
Yes, exactly. The national political parties, the political parties of the country, they are playing with the bloods of the people of Assam. They are trying to politicalize this issue. They are trying to take advantage out of this situation. Clearly, they are using the bloods of Assam for their political benefit. They should stop it. It is not the ground reality. And the ground reality is very clear. The Assam Chief Minister Tarun Gogoi has failed repeatedly to prevent communal violence in Assam in last 12 years. The Assam Chief Minister had the information about this incident, but he had failed to act upon it.
How do you know he had the information?
As the Home Minister of the state, he had the information. And during the election time in that area, it's a very sensitive zone. The Election Commission and the Government of India, Government of Assam, they had deployed more forces in that area. But just after the election, they had withdrawn the whole forces. They should not have done this. But the Home Minister of the state, the Chief Minister of the state, Mr. Tarun Gogoi, had the information. They had the intelligence input. But having that in intelligence input, they had failed to act upon it.
Priyanka Chaturvedi, how cowardly is it?
The Congress government had failed.
Priyanka Chaturvedi, how cowardly is it that your state government does not take responsibility? You use this issue to take pot shots at Narendra Modi. One second. Who is responsible for the law and order in Assam? Did the state government know? And most importantly, Priyanka Chaturvedi, your own ally, the Bodoland People's Front, your own ally in Assam, the Bodoland People's Front, stand accused of triggering the flare-up in this case. You understand how serious that is?
Now, can I answer? Absolutely, I understand the entire issue and I understand it is very serious. Now, having said that, please understand that this region has been going through a lot of ethnic strife and we admit that there have been violences, there have been cases of violence. Now, when he says that they had intelligence, I do not know, he seems to know more than everybody else seems to know about this particular violence. Now, I would just like to mention something here. Now, when you accuse us of having an alliance with somebody, are you aware, have you brought this to everyone's notice, that NDFB, BJP candidate from Tezpur, was in constant touch with NDFB people,
Sudhanshu Trivedi,
the rebel Bodo people.
What are you suggesting?
Rebel
the BJP
group of Bodos. One second, please let me explain. And he has gone on channel, on television, where he admits that he has been funding NDFB to get support for his candidature and to win. So are you trying, we need to understand, it's not about politicizing, but this particular violence that erupted
the charge
is
you
a
make
result
is serious.
Of the
it
political
must be answered. Kiran Raijuju,
the
charge is serious. You have used this charge not to answer the question. And let me remind you, Priyanka Chaturvedi, that an MLA of your ally party, the BPF, her name is Pramila Rani Brahma, has said 2 days back, before the riots, that Muslims in the area had voted for a former Ulfa commander who was contesting as an independent. And as a result, the BPF may lose. In other words, the first reference to religion provoking this kind of an attack was made by your Congress party ally. You have not answered that. But
if we are talking about provoking, please do understand. When a Mr. Narendra Modi, who is a prime ministerial candidate, goes to Tezpur, he compares rhinos and to Muslims and Hindus to Muslims to Bangladeshis and rhinos.
Arnab,
to
this is a very very unfortunate.
I think you are not aware.
Priyanka, with the same brush,
Priyanka Chaturvedi.
One second, they have been.
You are not aware of the ground reality here. I'm afraid. You are not aware of the ground reality.
I am quite aware, Mr. Goswami.
You are absolutely.
I'm absolutely aware.
You are completely not aware
of what I'm talking.
Miss Chaturvedi, you are not aware.
And you need to. I'm sorry, Mr. Goswami. You need to also question. You also need to question BJP's role in this entire thing. For them, victory is more important. Seems to be more important.
I have one question. One second. I find it a little strange. I must say, I just want to come in once again, Kiran. I find it a little strange that the Congress spokesperson on the program tonight says she will not ask a single question to the Congress party's ally who has tried to divide the electorate on Hindu-Muslim lines. Is that secularism? Miss Priyanka Chaturvedi?
No, I'm sorry.
Secularism provokes violence?
I did not say any such thing.
Kiran Raiju responding. She's made a counter charge to the BJP quietly is provoking violence.
But we also need to take into account what they've been
games
with NDFB for victory.
Can I come in? It is very unfortunate. Sure. It is very unfortunate the Congress spokesperson, instead of taking the responsibility, the state government is run by the Congress party, the central government is run by the Congress party. Instead of taking moral responsibility, administrative responsibility, they are talking of Narendra Modi and BJP responsible for all these kind of tragedies. It is most unfortunate. I would like to condemn this kind of attitude from the politicians.
This is not the time to blame. We need to get together and go beyond politics. You cannot put words in my mouth, but if we are questioning the state government, we also need to understand that particular place is a tinderbox.
Miss Chaturvedi, this is a nice...
The Congress should resign. If Congress cannot contain the situation, they have been striving to bring peace into that region. State of Assam as well as the center.
I'm sorry, very unfortunate. When we talk about moral authority, we have worked hard to ensure that there's peace in that land, but we also need to understand
peace,
the history
Ms. Chaturvedi,
of Assam.
What kind of peace are you talking about, Ms. Chaturvedi?
This incident is not the first time. What kind of peace are you talking about?
Are you aware?
Come in, please.
What kind of peace is Ms. Chaturvedi talking about? Are you aware that two senior leaders of the Bodoland People's Front had been arrested in 2012 for their suspected role in the violence that engulfed Kokrajhar? That another of the leaders talks about dividing the electorate on Hindu-Muslim lines? Did you take action against them?
Why are you concentrating on only one candidate, Mr. Goswami? I'm asking you a question.
Why don't you break your alliance with the party that talks the common language?
Why have they been meeting with rebel voter groups?
Is it therefore appropriate in your view, Ms. Chaturvedi? Is it appropriate in your view for your party ally to go ahead and say whatever they want?
Arnab, let me come in here.
Provoking the violence?
No, it is absolutely not appropriate.
Then what action have you taken against them?
It is not appropriate if someone has said something like
someone
this.
Someone has said something, your ally has said something. Who's someone?
No, I'm very clear.
It's a party. Sudhanshu Trivedi, the question goes to you. If people are playing this kind of politics,
but we also need to understand a prime ministerial candidate of the opposition party comes and talks, talks on communal lines. That is a question that needs to be asked as well.
Okay. Sudhanshu Trivedi is responding to it. Narendra Modi addressed rallies in Assam in the three following places in Borpeta, Mangaldoy and Naugaon. As far as I am aware,
Please ask him about the Tezpur candidate who went on camera and admitted that he had paid money to NDFB for their support.
Let Sudhanshu Trivedi answer that. Sudhanshu Trivedi, is the
Forget
BJP silently provoking
what
the
an
violence?
MLA is saying, what an MP is saying, and what a candidate is saying. I am quoting you an incident on the 24th April polling. There was an incident of firing in which the one policeman was killed and so many people got injured. Why it happened? Because some sort of mischievous SMSs were going on, which has created an irritation in the Muslim community. There was a clear-cut, visible incidence of violence. What Tarun Gogoi Sarkar has done in the last 10 days? They have done nothing.
Now they are trying to blame BJP when the problem is having the date back to 1983
when they brought the IMDT Act. and now they are blaming the Modi way for this. It is just like a phrase in ancient Sanskrit scripture which
Mr.
is called Kakalinai. It
means you seem to have not got the question. The question
of a tree
is about your Tezpur candidate
so
going on camera
rotten from
admitting
inside,
that he has
that
been funding
to fall
NDSB
as soon
to
as
win
a bird
that particular
on it,
seat.
And as soon
why
as it falls,
no,
then put the entire
been,
blame on that bird. That by the weight of that bird, the entire branch has fallen. This is the strategy of the Congress party who are responsible for all sorts of
the argument being put out here. No, no, one second.
They have done nothing.
The argument
being
put out. I would
like to quote one more thing. Congress is in power since 10 years, more than 10 years in Assam.
Mr. Trivedi, you refuse to answer the question about your Tezpur candidate going on camera admitting he is giving funds.
Instead of candidate, I am giving you the example of the incident.
Why aren't you talking about that?
What the government has said in 24th of April. And moreover, when the Supreme Court has quashed the IMDT Act in 2005, they have said it amounts to external aggression over India. What your government has done in the last 9 years? Nothing. Because you are so much mesmerized with the vote bank politics that you are compromising even on the national security. This is the root cause of the problem.
Joining into the debate tonight. One second, Priyanka Chaturvedi. I'd like to get Tanvir Sadiq and Asaduddin Owaisi at this stage.
Your Prime Minister is candidate.
You know something, it is so sad. It is so sad. No, no, one second.
It's a shame that you refuse to acknowledge East Bengali Muslims.
Whether it is Mumbai.
It's a shame. It's a shame.
Priyanka, 1 minute. Priyanka,
that
just a minute.
That you keep terming everybody
Priyanka,
as Bangladeshi immigrants.
Priyanka,
that is a bigger shame.
Priyanka, it is all right to ask Narendra Modi the questions about what he has said on Bangladeshi's
no,
illegal infiltrants. But
Modi. It's about their candidates. No, it's
but
about
Ms.
their
Ms.
candidates.
But Ms. Chaturvedi, you are going on like a broken record.
Why aren't we going on asking
Ms.
that?
Ms. Chaturvedi, please remember one thing. Rhetoric cannot substitute fact. Aggression.
It is not
aggression.
It
cannot
is a
substitute
it
truth.
It is a fact, isn't it a fact?
Aggression
isn't it a
cannot
fact that
substitute
we have been
truth.
NDSB?
And similarly, repeating
and again,
one thing ad nauseam.
Mr. Goswami,
Ms. Chaturvedi, repeating one thing ad nauseam does not allow you to deflect
violence
on the news.
So many people got killed. What action Tarun Gogoi government has taken?
An inquiry.
Ms. Chaturvedi, I am afraid. I am afraid. You are absolutely. I am sorry to say this. Ms. Chaturvedi. Ms. Chaturvedi,
sorry,
you have been tutored into repeating one
Mr.
point repeatedly
Mr.
on the news. Ms. Chaturvedi.
No, I'm not making any repeated points.
Ms. Chaturvedi, now please listen. Please listen, Ms. Chaturvedi.
No,
please listen. You have to.
You
I have to go to the other panelists. You can't dominate the debate. Please listen,
no,
Ms. Chaturvedi.
To them.
Please listen, Ms. Chaturvedi. This is an. Don't try and obfuscate the news by repeating one point ad nauseam. I have heard you. You made your point there. I can similarly ask you today,
no,
go and check the facts. Ms. Chaturvedi, I don't think there's anything
point,
for you. Ms. Chaturvedi, I'll just tell you one thing now. You know, I don't want to keep repeating it, and I don't think this is a good strategy. If this is a strategy you want to adopt, then it is, by the way, Ms. Chaturvedi, a very transparent strategy. A strategy which appears that you have come into the news hour having made your mind that you will keep talking. A, you will not listen to any question. B, you will not answer any question. C, and if you're asked a question on which you are on the back foot, then you will keep repeating the same point ad nauseam. D, right?
No,
that's
not
good.
Not.
Now, the fact of
absolutely
the matter
not.
Is that on
if
April 20th, on April 20th, Ms. Chaturvedi, on April 20th, the Kokrajhar District Administration promulgated 144 CRPC along the Indo-Bhutan border from 6 a.m. of April 23rd to 6 a.m. of April 24th. Go and find out a press release issued by the Kokrajhar Deputy Commissioner. You call him right now. His name is Nitin Khade. They said there's a likelihood of the movement of militants on the Indian side of the border during the election period. When you ask questions here about intelligence failure, the simple question is being asked, why did your government not act immediately? And no, having and therefore my question to Tanvir Sadiq and to Asaduddin Owaisi is this. Fine. Can you blame Modi for what has happened in Assam? Is Modi responsible for what has happened in Assam,
okay,
Tanvir Sadiq? Or are you using it for whatever political
okay,
advantage you can in
first
JNK?
First of all, you know, all right, first of all, my heart goes out to all the 33 families. I mean, I'm amazed that BJP guy is more concerned about Modi wave than, you know, at least sending his heartfelt condolences to the family. Now, let's get to the fact. You know, if two individuals fight, that's not a problem. But when two communities fight, it's a serious problem because communities don't one fine morning feel that, you know, they have nothing else to do than to fight. There's a concerted effort to instigate the community. And it has to have a mind that does not work to think that Modi...
Who instigated in August 2012?
Because what he said
Who instigated in August 2012?
On the contrary, the fact is that instead of playing condolences for that, for those people who have died.
Let me complete, because I know
you are blaming the Modi wave.
Okay, let me complete first and then you can say what you want to say.
It is not the BJP.
I know the BJP guys don't like
that. Sitting in the Kashmir.
Okay. Okay, let's come to the fact. Let's come to the facts now. Now, this man goes on and says in a rally, says that he's going to pack all. You know, he paints all the Muslims with a illegal immigrant brush and says that when he comes to power, he will pack them off. In the same breath, says, okay, you know what? When I come to power, all those people from one community, if they come to, if there is a safe place, there is
a Bangladeshi infiltrator.
If a prime ministerial candidate who is trying to be the savior of India suddenly speaks this language, I feel I'm very sorry about how the future of this country will be. Number one, I mean, I see no reason. Somebody has said that Modi denotes, you know, model of divided India. I think that's the real name somebody has put him. So I believe, you know, it was a concerted effort wherever they went.
Mr. Kapil Sibal must be ashamed. He should be ashamed of making Narendra Modi as an issue when the innocent people are being killed.
Dividing India. I mean, you guys, Subramaniam Swamy, your so-called tall leader, has been on record saying that he will divide Muslims and unite Hindus. What kind of politics are you playing here? I mean, this man goes 3 days before and then after 3 days you have a...
I want to ask this so-called secular parties what kind of politics you are playing.
We are playing politics. We are playing secular politics.
It is very unfortunate. Even from Kashmir
Mr. Tanvir Sadiq, please, just a minute. I know today that you run a state government which is so weak that it cannot take on the terrorists in Jammu and Kashmir who go on a killing spree against sarpanches.
Are you then insulting the army?
You have a chief minister. You have
a chief. Insulting the army who has sacrificed so much to keep peace in this country, the state.
You are not aware of the situation in Assam, Mr. Tanvir Sadiq.
If 1.5 million tourists can come today, it's because of the efforts of the state.
This is not your advertisement for the Jammu and Kashmir government on the news. This is a serious issue. Don't milk every massacre for political purposes. Samujjal Bhattacharya responding. Don't milk every massacre for your political purposes. Look at the ground level situation out here. There has been an act of provocation by a Congress party ally. Will you not speak about it because you too are a Congress party ally? Because your alliance with the Congress is more important than you're taking a firm position on the issue? Where is your sense of morals here, sir? Mr. Tanvir Sadiq, Samujjal Bhattacharya responding to you. Samujjal Bhattacharya to Tanvir Sadiq, go ahead.
Yeah. I'd like to appeal and I'd like to warn all the political parties not to play with the bloods of the people of Assam. They should not try to politicalize the issue of Assam because the ground reality is something different. I'd like to clarify one thing, that the issue of Assam is not a communal thing. It's not a clash in between Hindu and Muslim. Some armed group had killed some of the Islam people in the state of Assam. It's not a clash in between the Hindu people and Muslim people. It's not a Hindu-Muslim clash. We should be very clear on that. And all political parties, they should not try to politicalize this issue. Rather, they should try to solve this burning problem of Assam. And it is very clear the Assam Chief Minister, the incompetent Chief Minister, he has failed to prevent the communal disturbance in the state of Assam.
Your Prime Minister
and regarding that Modi's statement in Bengal. And Modi's statement regarding the illegal foreigners problem in Assam, we can discuss this problem in another day also. It's a vast problem. And we have seen the activities of Congress, BJP, and other political parties regarding the solution of the Bangladesh problem and implementation of Assam Accord.
Asaduddin Owaisi
have been massacred. I mean, what kind of politics you
Asaduddin Owaisi and Prem Shukla.
At this stage of the debate,
I'd like to invite Asaduddin Owaisi and Prem Shukla. My question here is to Asaduddin Owaisi and then to Prem Shukla. Who is responsible more for what has happened in Assam? The Congress-led government, which has been unable to act against its own ally, the BPF, which has been found to be provoking violence. Is the Congress therefore more responsible, Asaduddin Owaisi, Or is Narendra Modi more responsible because of the strident position he took that when and if he comes to power, he will act against illegal infiltrants? I would like to point out that those people who have been killed here are not all illegal infiltrants. There are Muslim settlers. Not all of them are illegal infiltrants. They are Muslim settlers. Asaduddin Owaisi, who's more responsible, and do you support the National Conference when it holds Modi responsible?
Arnab Goswami, let me first correct you. Stop calling them settlers. They are Indian citizens. Secondly, I put the blame both on Congress and BJP, but more on Congress, because this is an administrative-sponsored genocide of Muslims of Assam who are Indian citizens. Secondly, the Congress spokesperson is not talking about who is Siddiq Ahmed. Siddiq Ahmed is the minister in Tarun Gogoi's ministry who says that BTAD is responsible. And you're absolutely right that but for that statement of that lady Pramila Rai Brahma, this thing has happened. And she harps on NDFB. So why isn't Tarun Gogoi arresting the BJP candidate and NDFB? Because NDFB is a banned organization. You book the BJP candidate in Unlawful Activities Act. And lastly, Mr. Arnab Goswami, I am quoting to you 2 hours ago, Indian Express website, it quotes the speech of Mr. Narendra Modi given today in West Bengal in Bankura, where he says illegal people must go, but Hindu refugees are allowed. Please understand that this for the first time this sort of language is used in West Bengal. And he says that people who pray Durga Puja are allowed in India. People who have Indian blood in their veins can come to India. I mean, this is a classic Zionist policy which Israeli government is adopting.
Which goes against what Kiran Rijiju says that this is...
Therefore, let me complete. Your first question about who is responsible, I feel Tarun Gogoi is the Modi of Assam. He has to be blamed. He has deliberately closed his eyes towards the genocide of children, Adivasis,
Mr.
Hindu Bangladeshis,
please don't
Hindu,
use Bengal,
Bengali
Modi
people over there.
This is what
Tarun Gogoi has done. So as far as I am concerned, there is no difference between Mr. Tarun Gogoi and the politics practiced by Mr. Modi in Gujarat. Both are responsible for genocide of innocent Indians. Mr. Tarun Gogoi is doing the same thing. And you mark my words.
What about 16, people like Mr. Owaisi? What about people like Mr. Asaduddin Owaisi? First of all, you say
I
here,
am, you like
Asaduddin Owaisi, 1 minute.
Whether
Mr. Owaisi.
I am not responsible for genocide.
Mr. Owaisi.
I am not responsible for Naroda Party.
I'd like to remind you about something.
For making Zakia Jafri.
I'd like to remind you about something.
I am not responsible. Yes, you can. You can remind me of anything.
I would like to remind you about something.
It is the courts of law will decide.
Mr. Owaisi.
Let me remind you.
Let me remind you.
He was exonerated. Of course.
Let me remind you of something, because it appears to me that you're afraid of being reminded of something. Are you afraid of my reminding you about something?
No, I am not afraid of you or anyone else.
Okay, so don't be afraid of
me. Because you must give me opportunity to rebut you.
I will certainly. I want both.
You must give me opportunity to rebut you.
I will, but don't get nervous. I would just like to point out here that I will ask Prem Shukla to respond.
You invite me and you get nervous. If I don't come on your program, your correspondent calls me 5 times in a day and you're telling me I'm nervous. Boss, you call me.
Mr. Owaisi, there is a fundamental difference.
Now, don't tell me.
There is a fundamental difference.
If you feel I'm nervous, don't call me.
I was just looking at your body language there, Mr. Owaisi. My question is, and I will get, I remember a certain Mr. Us, you say tonight, and we agree therefore, that if the issue is a demographic issue, what is happening in Assam, it must not be given a religious spin. First of all, do we all agree that to give a communal angle to what is an issue of ethnic unrest between communities, that communal angle should not be given? First of all, do we agree on that? Having agreed on that, I would like to remind Mr. Owaisi.
No, I don't agree with you. I don't agree with you.
I
don't agree with you.
That's the issue,
point.
Mr. Owaisi. That's the issue, isn't it? The issue is that you say one thing but you do another. Ask Samujal Bhattacharya, who is from Guwahati today, that the last thing that needs to be done in the state of Assam is to create communal strife. It may serve your interests, Mr. Owaisi. to create communal strife, because you will go there, you will parachute, you will create communal strife.
Small children have been butchered over there. What interest do I have to serve? People have been made widows over there. How low can you go, Mr.
Because Mr. Owaisi says, because Mr. Owaisi, you said, because Mr. Owaisi, you said this.
I have not said in Bankura. Why don't you use the Mr.
My question is this simple.
Small children have been butchered. Have you not seen the photographs of how children have been killed?
Mr. Owaisi, remember this. Remember this. A mix of terrorism and communal strife is a dangerous cocktail. No country wants it. No state needs it. Communal strife and terrorism together. The people will pay a price.
Why do you have the guts to tell them on their face?
Then Mr. Sadiq, I ask you tonight. I ask you a question of guts.
Who is the forest ranger?
On an issue of
forest rangers have been arrested.
On an issue of guts.
A
question goes here.
You can talk about ethnic cleansing. You can talk about any other thing.
You have done ethnic cleansing in Kashmir Valley, na?
The whole BJP.
Your Omar Abdullah has never criticized it.
Why?
Your Omar Abdullah has done ethnic cleansing in Kashmir Valley. What are you doing about the Hindu pandits?
Oh, really?
Why you are not rehabilitating them? We are not communalizing the issue, but you are communalizing the issue.
You don't know then.
We know better than you.
You don't know.
Because you have never tear for the Hindu pandits. But your Omar Abdullah, he is making a childish statement with separatist statement.
You don't know how many people have come here.
3 lakhs people are even today in the transit camps. You know that?
We are creating a
condition. No, you are not creating anything. You have done ethnic cleansing and you have never even made any statement against the militants.
Wherever BJP has gone.
The poor people who massacred Hindus, you have never. You have never made any statement against the militants. And you are making statements in the Assam. There is a demographic issue and you are communalizing it. There is confrontation between illegal immigrants and the son of soil. And you are trying to communalize it. You are trying to communalize it.
Are you trying to justify the massacre?
No, we are not trying to justify.
Are you trying to justify the massacre?
We can't justify the violence.
I mean, you can't.
But they are communalizing it. But they are communalizing it. Who are communalizing? Mr. Owaisi is communalizing it by saying they are Muslims. They were not massacred because they were Muslims. And the confrontation is between the borderland and the those illegal immigrants. Everyone know why the Nelli massacre was done. And the Congress party.
Are you justifying the Nelli massacre?
I'm not justifying.
Then take it back.
But I'm not taking any action against them. Hitesh Saikia was never. There was no action against Hitesh Saikia. There is no action against Tarun Gogoi. And they are blaming Narendra Modi.
What Priyanka Chaturvedi, Asaduddin Owaisi says here, Tarun Gogoi is the Narendra Modi of Assam. He said that. One second. To Priyanka Chaturvedi, I want to respond to Asaduddin Owaisi.
I will reply to Mr. Owaisi.
Reply to Mr. Owaisi and Mr. Owaisi alone, Priyanka.
She will not reply.
Reply to Mr. Owaisi. Reply to Mr. Owaisi.
Reply to Mr. Owaisi. Come to the point. Narendra Modi of Gujarat and Tarun Gogoi of Assam, two differences are, firstly...
No, never. How can you say there are two different things?
No, one second.
Let Mr. Owaisi will respond to her.
When violence broke out in Assam, army was deployed instantly.
What have you done to protect
the... How Mr. Narendra Modi behaved during the 2002 riots. When we have violence in Assam, we have the chief minister demanding for an NIA
what probe demand? And not he was also to demanding
do,
for the central
do a state level even probe Narendra and Modi ending it there and then.
Demanding
you
the central
not,
forces
in Assam,
Gujarat.
When there are riots, the you do not have a chief minister
there was
who took action
Godra
and reaction. While
then
in Gujarat,
the retaliation
a 2002
of the,
is justified by action and reaction.
The riots.
There's a huge difference. You need to understand that.
Ms. Chaturvedi, I'd like to tell you once again. A minute, please. Please remember. Rhetoric does not substitute fact, and knowledge of what is happening on the ground level of the issue does not substitute repeating one issue ad nauseum. Kokrachar has witnessed bloody clashes that began in August 2012, in which more than 80 people were killed, in which 400,000 people had to seek refuge in 200 relief camps. Today, the violence has happened in the same region. Why should your state government not be held responsible? Why should it not be held responsible? I want you to contradict if you can on fact, Asaduddin Owaisi.
Mr. Goswami, at no point, you cannot bully me into saying the words that you want me to say.
You don't. You have to answer the question.
Why
does a riot happen again and again in a Congress ruled state?
No, it's just that if I answer something which is contradictory.
Why does a riot happen again and again in the same place in a Congress ruled state?
I have clearly said in Assam, Mr. Gogoi has asked for an NIA investigation.
Oh, NIA investigation. Asaduddin Owaisi, your response to the Congress spokesperson.
Yes, we have asked for it.
Asaduddin Owaisi. Asaduddin Owaisi is responding.
Mr. Goswami, that you do not seem to understand the
Mr.
two.
Mr. Owaisi is responding. I heard you there. Mr. Owaisi is responding to you now. Mr. Owaisi.
Sure.
Madam, please tell the nation who is Siddiq Ahmed. How is it that your own minister is saying that you are a liar? He is saying that your government, your ally is responsible. And 8 rangers, madam, forest rangers have been arrested. I mean, come on, accept the responsibility. What has happened would not have happened but for the connivance of BTAD area over there. You harp about NDFB. Why haven't your Tarun Gogoi, the great Tarun Gogoi, arrested them so far? And you mark my words, come May 16th, this top Hindutva adopted by this Tarun Gogoi. Listen to me. Listen to no. Listen to me. Listen. What investigation? What investigation
are you talking about?
Why don't you show the same anger as you shown towards in what happened in Gujarat? It is your government. You want us to close our eyes? No. People have been butchered over there. Children have been killed over there. Automatic weapons. What has your government done in 2 years to seize illegal automatic weapons? What is the government doing? Sleeping over there? What are they doing? You coming on national and say that you are doing? What are you doing? What will NIA do? Will they bring back the lives? 50 people are still missing now. Children have been made orphans over there.
And you say,
I don't need to understand. It's a genocide over there of people over there. And your government is sleeping over there.
Today we are accused of soft Hinduism. We are accused of bringing in illegal immigrants for votes. This is absolutely ridiculous.
Well, you've been accused of soft Hindutva.
There is no illegal immigrants.
No, this is not Hindutva.
Muslims have been killed because they didn't vote for a border candidate.
Why have they been killed? On the other side of the news tonight,
I take a break. I'm taking a break because on the other side of the news tonight, I will ask the BJP one question. The BJP faces charges that its leaders met some terrorist leaders of the NDFB with regard to the elections. And therefore, the question on the other side is what is happening in Assam? Is it a dangerous cocktail of communal vitriol mixed with terrorism? And if the politicians of Assam and national level politicians do not show the spine to call a spade, then who will? We are back tonight because when Assam is burning, national politicians can't just be sniping. I'm back in a few minutes. Samujal Bhattacharya of the All India, All Assam Students Union, do you trust the BJP on this? Do you trust the BJP on the subject or do you think they're also simply taking political advantage of the situation?
See, all political parties, they should stop mudslinging on the issue of Assam. There are two issues. One regarding Kokrajhar Baska issue, one is foreign national issue. This Baska and Kokrajhar issue, regarding that issue, the Assam Chief Minister had failed. He is an incompetent Chief Minister. He had failed to act upon after getting the intelligence input. Second, regarding the foreign national issue, it's a big issue, it's a vex issue. The all political parties, they had failed and will watch what they will do after this election. That's a different thing. But I'd like to request, through your channel, that no political party should communalize this issue. It's not a Hindu-Muslim clash. I'm repeating again. An armed group had killed people. It's not a Hindu-Muslim clash. It's not a clash between two villages.
Exactly. Let the BJP answer that. Let Sudhanshu Trivedi answer that. You only want to communalize the entire issue and so does the National Conference by giving it a particular spin. It suits you politically. But let me ask you, Sudhanshu Trivedi, after this incident, your party leader Ravi Shankar Prasad says that this incident between Boros and immigrant Bangladeshis has happened. How does he know that one group is that of immigrant Bangladeshis? Of the 32 people who have died, all of whom are Muslims, does he know? Does your party know who is an immigrant Bangladeshi and who is an Indian Why don't you officially determine who is dead, who is a Bangladeshi, who is immigrant and who is an Indian before jumping to conclusions to about their identity? Mr. Sudhanshu Trivedi, why do you do politics even over those who have been killed? Why do you do that? On the corpses of the victims, you are doing politics.
Unfortunately, it has been not determined since last 30-35 years.
But do you know
Congress brought the change
the 32 people who died, do you know they are infiltrators?
And they always try to stop the any process which do, is capable sir, of determining sir, those
sir, infiltrators. Sir, so what? You don't even know the facts?
That's why.
Sir, you are calling...
When our government was there, the so, PIL was
Asaduddin Owaisi is responding to that.
It was by our present Assam unit president, Mr. No. Sarvanand Sonwal.
Sir, do you know who's...
And in favor of which Supreme Court given a judgment.
Sir, do you know who's an illegal...
This is the irony of the situation.
I
and
think
moreover, we are not at all in favor of
sir, do you know,
stopping
do you
the
know,
terrorism and the community.
But you've
but
just done it.
But look at these parties.
But you've just done it.
Ms. Priyanka's party, Congress, whose home minister openly says that Muslim youth should be dealt with softly, though even they are booked under terrorist act.
Sir, you, why don't you, first of all,
if you're going to keep comparing, then let's have
Parliament.
A comparison of
and
why
Mr.
didn't you ask Mr. Narendra Modi to step down after 2002?
Whose brother uses to say, leave
talk about your party and how it has failed.
Teach them a lesson in 20 minutes. These type of parties who dastardly brand the communal politics with terrorism, they cannot do good for the country.
Exactly. When you call these Bengali Muslims as Bangladeshis, it's a shame that you'll tar them with the same brush. Immigration
I want
is a
to ask you the question.
Admit,
in the last 35 years and 10 years, why you are unable to
Bengali
identify
Muslim,
who are the infiltrators? When the governor
right.
in 2006, the Assam governor has given a report that on an average every day, 5,000 people uses to cross the border. It is the report
and
of your
you
governor
do,
in 2006.
Sir? And what did
and
you do, sir?
The IMDT Act, the determination is 0.5%.
What did you do, sir? What did the BJP do, sir, for the 6 years that it was in power?
BJP has done...
Done what?
Our government...
You have done precious
we have
little.
The Borderland Council...
You have done precious little.
We have filed a case against court.
You have only made infiltration an issue. You have only made the charge against you, sir. Sir, the charge against you, and you can ask this question to anyone, including the people in Assam.
And the court judgment came...
Everyone will tell you that you have only made infiltration into a communal issue to be exploited at the national level. The fact remains that in Dhemaji, Serampur, Modi made controversial remarks, and I'm getting Asaduddin Owaisi to respond to this. Narendra Modi says the expulsion of illegal immigrants from Bangladesh. He's spoken of the expulsion of illegal immigrants from Bangladesh, but at the same time he's called for the rehabilitation of persecuted Hindus from Bangladesh to India. Is that not a communal remark? Why draw a distinction on the basis of someone's religious identity?
It is a distinction between a genuine refugee and the infiltrator.
A Hindu is a genuine refugee and a Muslim is not.
And forget about the Hindu.
Asaduddin Owaisi. Asaduddin Owaisi.
They are not tribal.
Asaduddin
Owaisi. Can they be called the infiltrator if we come to the side of India? No. There has to be a clear policy about the genuine refugee and the infiltrator who is even involved in the terrorist activities.
Asaduddin Owaisi is responding
Arnab,
to this.
Arnab, let me define.
I'd like to remind Asaduddin Owaisi Arnab, of the statements he has himself made in Parliament.
Arnab, let me come into it.
Okay, Kiran Rijiju before that.
See, let us understand this first, Arnab. A illegal migrant is totally different from refugee. Refugees are the group of people who have been forced, persecuted, or been sent by force from their own homeland. Illegal migrants are different set of people. When Narendra Modi says that illegal migrants are to be sent back, this is absolutely correct statement. As an Indian, we want foreigners to come here with proper documents, but we will never welcome any illegal migrants. But let us not dilute that issue with the present situation.
But hasn't the BJP
the present
done
situation,
that?
The tragedy
hasn't the BJP done that?
Is
the
purely
BJP
law and order problem.
Hasn't the BJP done that by calling all the 32 people who have been killed
no,
illegal migrants?
We must understand that.
Did you do that or not? Did you make the issue? Did you make the issue?
See,
did you mix up the two issues or not?
We must understand that Narendra Modi's statement should not be brought into this issue. What I'm saying is,
I am asking
the
you
present incident of killing
Ravi Shankar Prasad, Mr. Rijuju,
failure of law and order control of the state government.
Mr. Rijuju, Ravi Shankar Prasad says that this is an issue of clashes between Boros and illegal Bangladeshis. The point is, these are not clashes. This is a massacre.
That is history.
These are not clashes. This is a killing. This is a terror attack. Why is he linking it up to the issue of illegal infiltration? Why is it? He is a leader of your party. You belong to the BJP. You tell me why. Sudhanshu Trivedi, tell
me why. I accept. Mr. Ravishankar Prasad is saying he is pointed out towards the genesis of the problem.
Do you
know? Why we are trying to hide the eyes?
Then do you know?
We are trying to hide the fact. We are trying to avoid looking at the basic genesis of the problem.
Sir, please understand this. According to the Assam Accord of 1985, please check your facts. People from Bangladesh who had come over before January 1966 were to be regularized as Indian nationals. I'm asking you, should the BJP not determine who the dead are? Those children, those women who have been killed, how do you know that they are Bangladeshis? And if you don't know that they are Bangladeshis, why are you dubbing them Bangladeshis?
What is the religion of those people killed?
Sir, religion and nationality, you mixed it up. Samujal Bhattacharya. Samujal Bhattacharya has the BJP become completely confused.
As an Indian.
Mr. Bhattacharya has the BJP completely confused on the issue.
Is that the tension?
BJP is completely confused on the issue.
We have seen that the Congress party has failed to implement the land of the indigenous people.
The left party started there. That is the genesis of the problem. But the immediate problem is
the illegal Bangladeshi who have entered after 71 after Assam Accord, they must leave Assam. He may be Hindu, he may be Muslim. There cannot be division in the name of illegal Bangladeshi. Illegal Bangladeshi is a Bangladeshi. He may be Hindu, he may be Muslim. As per Assam Accord, those have entered after 71, they must leave. And one thing is very clear, that Narendra Modi had given this statement in Bengal after the election of Assam. There is no link in between the present class and Narendra Modi's statement.
Related to Assam, to Northeast, where I feel that the political leaders of the nation should understand and address the issue rather than trying to make it as a political issue.
You know who does politics on this? I would like to say here now that one person who's done politics over this is Mr. Asaduddin Owaisi. And Mr. Asaduddin Owaisi has added a full religious angle to this issue. He said, Mr. Asaduddin Owaisi said in a speech in Parliament during the 2012 violence, and he said this. He said, I warned the members of Parliament. And he'll remember this. He said, I warned the members of Parliament that if proper rehabilitation does not take place, he said, waving his finger, he said, you be ready for a third wave of radicalization among Muslim youth. What kind of language is that, Mr. Owaisi? And did you not make that comment?
Mr. Arnab Goswami.
Did you not make that comment, Mr. Owaisi? Does that not completely bust and demolish the high moral stance that you take on the news hour tonight?
I stand by it.
That's the problem. You see, that's the problem. Sitting there, in Hyderabad, you want to communalize the situation in Assam. You want to communalize the situation in Assam.
Parliamentary sovereignty is there.
You want to communalize the situation in Assam.
It is there in Parliament.
Sir,
I will take those words to my grave.
Sir, do you want to communalize the situation in Assam?
Has allowed that to remain on record.
You.
No, I am not communalizing.
You want to communalize the situation.
And when I say that you are killing me,
because it benefits you politically.
When I say you are killing me, you. I say I'm communalizing.
Because no,
when
it doesn't.
My children are being made orphans.
Mr. Owaisi,
I'm proud of the statement I made in Parliament.
You know, Mr. Owaisi.
Stand by it till the rest of my life.
You can do that, Mr. Owaisi, because you believe.
It will be the records. You cannot expunge it now.
Because you believe.
I stand by it.
I don't agree with it. I think these are the words of someone who wants to.
You are not talking about the statement made by Mr. Modi in Bankura.
I have
Mr.
said
Arnab
so.
Goswami, very cleverly, you are doing politics over here. Why aren't you not talking about the Bankura statement?
Mr. Owaisi, I'll tell you this. Mr. Owaisi, listen to me.
Who pray Durga Puja allowed in India?
Now,
please understand,
Mr. Owaisi, you were not listening 2 minutes back.
Don't please.
You were not listening 2 minutes back.
You are protecting Mr. Narendra Modi.
You are not listening two minutes back.
Protecting Narendra Modi.
Mr. Owaisi, I do not need lectures from you on the subject because I was the first person who asked the question when the BJP manifesto came out. And you have the courage to listen. You have the courage to listen, Mr. Owaisi. Mr. Owaisi, have the patience to listen.
What kind of language is Mr. Modi using?
Have the patience to listen. Mr. Owaisi, if you have the patience to listen, then I will tell you that the one channel which questioned the BJP manifesto, which then when said...
But no, you have never condemned the statement.
Now I would like to ask one question to Mr. Owaisi.
You never condemned Mr. Owaisi. The statements made by your own brother.
I would like to ask one question to Mr. Owaisi.
When he tried to insult the Bhartiya Janata Party,
what was his reaction when Azam Khan
made a statement against him?
That the Indian army, it was the Muslim soldiers who have conquered the Kargil by using the slogans like Allah Akbar and Narayan Tadbir. Has he condemned it?
I have condemned Azam Khan's statement.
Even in the part of army, he has not said that. Now I would like to ask the question to Congress.
You agree with your brother's 2 years back
when it was a statement.
You and Azam Khan are doing a Noora
Kishti. Mr. Asaduddin Owaisi's party was in alliance with Congress.
Because of you and Azam Khan, Congress
is a national party who are ruling in Andhra Pradesh, who are ruling at national level. Have you ever condemned the statement made by your own brother? I just want to know, have you ever condemned your brother's statement, Akbarudin Owaisi's statement, than a smaller party like MIM?
Arun Gandhi was exonerated by courts of law. The courts of law have exonerated my brother, inshallah. Don't worry about it.
But you never condemned you and me. You are condemning everybody.
Don't worry about it.
But you are not condemning your own brother.
Don't worry about it.
This is your
what about Bankura? This is how your condemned behavior is. Don't vote for Modi, should go to Pakistan. This is the same statement being made by Pramila.
But you are making statements and you will kill. Just give 15 minutes and we'll kill all the Hindus.
One second, don't communalize it.
No, no, he
is not. Do not communalize it. Do not communalize it. I say one thing once again. I make this fervent appeal. Assam is burning. Assam is on the edge. And let me tell you, for all those people who are homeless today and all those who live in fear tonight in Assam, it is not a comfortable thought to think that they are simply subjects and puppets for political fights at the national level. I would like to ask all the political parties to have the heart to consider in the middle of this campaign, send an all-party joint team to the state of Assam and see for yourself on the ground how the bloodshed has affected the people there, what insecurity that is. Don't just use it. Don't use it. Do not use it for politics. Do not use it for politics. Well, Tarun Gogoi should be responsible. Tarun Gogoi must be responsible. On that, I agree with you. Thank you very much for joining me on that News Hour debate.